Bucky Cunningham talking to Will and Halfpenny, and there's tonight's weather. Beautiful night here at Football Park. Fine and mild, a top of 23 degrees, almost 24 degrees, overnight low of 17 degrees. And of course, it should be a big game, the second game, Jumbo, between Port Adelaide and North Adelaide.
Yes, yeah, certainly a huge game. And it's interesting, with Bradkey going over to England, or to America, sorry, right. And passes being, you know, sort of nominated to be in the 36ers, Ken. That's interesting.
He's a really good player, Parsons. In fact, if he hadn't been good at footy, he certainly would have been a very, very good basketballer. But, gee, as you look at that Port Adelaide side, it's a very interesting side, and also North Adelaide. So let's go to Graham Campbell now for his expert tip. And, Graham, how do you see tonight's game?
You're asking my tunnel tip already, are you, Ken? Well, the Port side on paper does look awesome, quite frankly. They've got a lot of good players, Ken, but I do query their half-forward line. Playing Darren Smith on a half-forward flank, to me, is not the way to go. And certainly, it's a big punt, Danny Hughes, centre half-forward. That's how they'll line up, Ken. It may have seemed like a bogus line-up, but it's not.
What about Smallridge's game in the middle, Graham? Well, his last time performance was outstanding.
Ken, he was sensational last time he sported the black and white jumper. Nose over the ball, a hard doer, a bloke that knows no fear. He impressed me, Smallridge. He could be anything, I believe, Ken. And he has two twins out there also, as we well know, David Brown and the boy on the fence, Paul Kemp. And heaven knows if the three are on the ground together again tonight, we're in for some sort of problems identifying who's who, aren't we?
Yes, well, Graham, obviously the big thing tonight is Delaney and Fiachi, yeah. The old combination. Delaney back from Fitzroy, a huge boost for Port Adelaide.
Well, we know Roger Delaney is a very economical fullback, Rick. He left our competition as arguably the best fullback in the land over here. He's gone to Fitzroy and, well, he's had a very interrupted program over there. In fact, he only played one league game. He comes back now rearing to go, and I think big things to be expected of Roger Delaney.
Actually, Graham, looking at the North Adelaide side, Dittmar, brilliant at his best,
yep.
But is he consistent enough? He needs to do a little bit more up forward.
He impressed me the first week he played, Rick. I think he kicked 5 goals that particular match, but since then, not so prominent. He's dropped easy marks, in my opinion. He hasn't kicked the goals he should have kicked. Of course, he's led to the angles too often, I believe. You, as an ex-full forward, would know that. He's probably got to stop leading to the pockets and come more direct up the field and take those marks. And I think he'll be a player. But at the moment, there's a query about him.
Actually, Graham, I was most impressed with North Adelaide's defence last week. Carreau, coming back from a long stint with injury, I thought played pretty well at centre-half back. And, you know, they're a very good defensive side, North Adelaide.
What about Turner on a half-back flank, Ken? He was very good last week also. I was very impressed with Peter Turner. And they have really got what I consider the rebound halfback line of the competition. They all know how to get the ball and quickly feed it into their forward line, either with a hand pass or a quick kick. And their fullback line is very prominent also. North actually, Ken, from where I sit, they attack from their back line. They're very good at that.
Graham, the old skipper from Port Adelaide in Phillips, his form over the last couple of weeks, I've seen him a couple of times, has been ordinary. He needs to do a little bit more tonight.
Well, Rick, he's a bloke that warms to the task. I think we all felt when the season started, Greg Phillips was, shedding a bit of weight and getting himself match fit in this particular series. He'll be right for the first game of the year. Whatever he does tonight, he'll improve upon. He's just a bloke that needs plenty of football. And, you know, he's getting older. And with age, you put on weight, don't you, Rick?
Certainly do, Graham.
Graham, getting back to North Adelaide, it was their running players last time. Atkinson, when he came onto the ground after half-time, Saliba. I've been most impressed with young Tim Noonan. So it's their smaller players also that are playing well for North Adelaide.
Well, Ken, hit the nail on the head. What Coach Michael Noonan has done is introduce young kids around the pack, such as Tim Noonan and Josh Mayle. Now, Josh Mayle at the moment is holding Brodie Atkinson out of the side. But Brodie and what he showed us last week should be a starter tonight. He kicked 3 goals in the last half and really was a vibrant player. But nonetheless, you stay with the kids. I mean, they're all kids. I mean, Atkinson were probably 17. The other two blokes were about 16, I think. Not too sure of the ages, Ken, but they're all under 18. And it is a feather in the cap of Michael Noonan to play these kids and get a result out of them. And North are a very young, enthusiastic team. And to be honest, Ken, I'm going for North tonight. I'll go against the grain here. I'll go for North by, the mandatory 1-10. It should be a tight game. I think North can get over the line. I don't know why, but they can get over the line tonight.
Good on you, Graham. Still 1-10's gone for North Adelaide, Rick.
Certainly as well. I think Port Adelaide, I think that they're going to be very, very hard to beat tonight. Tyler up forward, huge. I think he can compete at centre-half forward.
He'll compete, but
I think Delaney at full-back and Fiachi, Georgie Porgy Pudney Pie, he'd love it at full-back. And I think you'll find that they'll be very keen to win tonight.
Well, I'm going for Port Adelaide. I think Port will win 11-20. And Ian Day is our caller, of course, and Daisy, Port or North?
Well, I think that man on your screen is going to make it hard for Port Adelaide. Mick Redden against young Brett Chalmers. He's going to give North first touch, but I like the experience of Port Adelaide. Ken, I'll stay with them. Everything in readiness now for the game. Port and North Adelaide. North with a couple of their senior players out. Sanders will be missed. But we've got Tyler at full forward for Port Adelaide, a valuable spearhead. It'll be just an interesting to see how the game will go. But Port Adelaide, when you look at this side, you'd hardly think that the Crows have touched them. They're looking particularly strong. Better crowd than normal at Footy Park, which is encouraging. There's maybe 7,000 people here. Beautiful night for football. And umpire Jeffrey Beans holds the ball up to indicate the game is underway. Chalmers from the right, Redden from the left, at the bounce. Chalmers gets the tap away, a good start for the... They go through hard, Redden gets the handball out, can't get it out. Finally, Williams comes out with a ball from Geneva. Floats one in towards full forward, Tyler there, can't find it. Setri gives it across to Boyd, oh, he can't get a handle on it at all. Tasker under pressure, quickly in there now is Noonan, he can't find it. Perkins lost a handle as well. In goes Stephen Williams, and the umpire's going to have to ball that up. Big opportunity then for Port Adelaide, not quite equal to the task. And the ball handling in that particular passage of play left a little bit aside. Hello, who's using who as a mat there? Just wiped his feet all over the Port Adelaide player on the ground, which, oh, on they go. Clock with the football, he seems to get legged. The umpire said play on. Getting underneath the ball, Turner, he can't find it. G. Rowe goes in hard, and umpire Semler, quite correctly, KG, comes in and calls a halt.
That is a terrific rule. Semler bounced the football, they were fighting. He got the footy, bounced the footy, and whoa, did that separate the brawl?
Yes, it was unfortunate for Port Adelaide in that instance, but as it turned out, caught holding the ball, and Steve Semler has given Port Adelaide a free, well, Ken, about 35 metres out.
And it's Setri who'll take the free kick.
Yes, and here you can see caught, there he is, caught holding the ball by Setri, and quite rightly so.
Setri going towards the lake end. Played only a minute and a half. Can the Magpies put their first major on the board? No, they can't. I think he's... very much off the target, only a minor score. Port Adelaide 1 point, North yet to score.
Yes, we all know Port Adelaide. They go straight up the centre, looking for Tyler. Hodges, of course, has left, and he's the man for the job. And it'll be very interesting tonight, Ken, to see just how he performs.
Tasta goes looking for Redden on the outer side. Abba's in there. Jason Rowe back in defence for the Roosters. Hooks back towards centre wing. Who's up there? Can't get it. Peter Bennett going through strongly was Barrett. Lost it. Coming off the half back line was Foster. Kicks long towards the half forward line, setting himself up there as Rowe lost what he should have grabbed. Williams gets it out, here's a chance, they can't get it clear. However, Ryan lost it, in there is Setri, in goes Rowe, over the top is Ryan, and the umpire will have to bounce the football on the Port Adelaide half forward line.
Very interesting there in your screen, number 25 I think it was, with the long Danny Hughes with the what do they call the bicycle shorts, Ken, and it's very interesting to see. Obviously there he is in your screen up against Redden. Very interesting to see how he comes back from Melbourne and performs tonight.
The kick by Abernethy has been sport. In fact, it goes out of play. So it's out of play with Port into attack. They've done most of the attacking in the opening moments of this first quarter here at Footy Park. We see Redden, Hughes, about to contest this throw-in. The big man Redden in front got it over beautifully on this occasion. Working hard is Klomp. Kicks around his body back towards the half back line, and the ball is forced out of play once more. Neither side able to set up any momentum at the moment, rather scrambly for play, but it's only early days, and this should build into a very good game of football. Hughes, Redden, over the top went Smith. Stephen Williams there working hard, but the ball again is forced out of play.
Yes, Ken, it's going to be very interesting to see the Port Adelaide forward line. They've lost most of their forward line this year, and to see Hughes at centre half forward, Smith on the half forward flank. Graham Campbell said, well, I wouldn't play him there, but a real scoring potential there, and it's going to be interesting to see how Port Adelaide score tonight.
Rowe throws it out, Setri can't find it. Coming through was Klopp, lost it, Smith. Oh, high tackle! Had to get a free kick for that. I think it was Stephen Riley was the transgressor, and the tackle was terrible. You can't call it anything else.
Yes, a bit unfortunate there. Stephen Riley right in for the kill and just a little bit high.
Darren Smith, point-blank range, only 25 metres out, should kick this. Port Adelaide are on the board with their first goal.
Yes, well, Port Adelaide have opened pretty strongly. First bounce of the opening minutes of the game, they went straight down the centre, and you can see here on your screen, Hughes there, Smith getting hold of the football. And right over the top comes Riley, and a bit unfortunate there, but he thought to himself, well, I've done the wrong thing, but I might as well sling him down just for the sake of it. And he went back and put through Port Adelaide's first goal.
Port 1-1,
what that I did to get under the scoreboard, into the middle. Saliba works hard. On that occurrence with Saunders, kick was smothered. Mark Williams, it's almost holding the ball. Back towards half 40 goes. The mark has been taken back there by Turner. Turner now from the half-back flank, one of the promising youngsters of the North Adelaide team. Towards half forward, over the top to Parsons. Parsons to Bennett was a casual handball. Put him under extreme pressure. Jennifer, he couldn't do much with the football. Over to the big man himself, Phillips. Jesus, size, he really is. Put it beautifully to Hutton. Port Adelaide are running up towards Setia. Beautiful kick by Hutton and finds Setia. Port Adelaide doing all the attacking. Tries to run around the man on the mark. Hooks it back towards goal. Which way will it go? I think it's home. That's Port Adelaide's second goal. A great one.
Yes, what a magnificent bit of play there by Port Adelaide. Looked very awesome here in the first quarter. Coming out from that half-back line. Beautiful play there. Putting the ball out in the open. You can see here Hutton. Oh, magnificent. Looking down the field, sees Sentry out by himself, put the ball out into the space, and Sentry could have played on and did so. Ripped around. Look at that. Beautiful movement. Saw the opportunity, played on and kicked Port Adelaide's second goal.
The Magpies shoot to a 13-point lead in the first 6 minutes of the game. At the bounce, Redden gets the tap away again. Beautifully done, Saliba. Farms it out, lost it. Here's a chance. Hutton gets it across now to the half forward line. Coming to meet it is Tyler. Well tended Tasker. Coming through, getting it out now was Riley. Under pressure, Turner going through Ryan. Oh, he can't find it either. Port with a chance through Boyd. Has the ball 30 metres out. Hooks. Goals. 3 and 6 minutes. Port doing it on the bit.
Yes, well, beautiful movement by Port Adelaide. They're going straight down the ground. They've got Darren Smith on one side. Look at the tackle. Right over the top. There's Bradley Ryan. He can't get near it. And there he is, Boyd, getting himself right over the top of the footy, uncontested. And he puts through Port Adelaide's third goal. And they're looking very, very sharp, very, very alert at this early point of the game.
Seven minute 10, and it's Port Adelaide 3-1. North yet to get onto the scoreboard. A chance for Barrett towards centre half forward Mayo. Oh, gee, it's a sloppy work, but Noonan takes the crumbs. But up towards half forward he goes. Parsons went up one hand. The other hand was to Hale. Dittmar works hard for the footy. Out it comes on this occasion to Mayo. Over to Saliba. That's good football. A chance for Saliba. He's next. Point blank range.
Yes, well, unfortunate there for North Adelaide. The first real challenge up forward that they've had, and there he is in your number 16 in your screen with the long hair. Unfortunate for North Adelaide, couldn't capitalise.
Roger Delaney making a welcome return to Port Adelaide from Fitzroy. A typical kick, ground covering as usual, towards centre wing. It's a match race out there. Abernethy playing centre wing this evening under pressure. Saunders gets it back. Parsons in turn. Turner goes back into Saunders, or didn't work hard enough for it. Fiachi off the half back line. Clump looking for it. Thumps it clear. Saliba over there in the middle as well. Lero getting under trouble. Marshall. Saliba whips out a handball. A chance here now. Going through is Perkins. Shoots in long, but he's offline again. 1 point only to North Adelaide, starting to regroup a little, getting a bit of method through their half-forward line, but kicking points.
Yes, well, if you're looking at the scoreboard, of course, if you're a North Adelaide supporter, 3 goals to nothing, you'd think that they're starting to put something together, and on that occasion, Perkins was a little bit wide.
Delaney kicked the ball in. Was made to kick it again. The umpire hadn't waved the flags. Goes long, looks out there for Smallridge, his first possession for the game. In Western Australia, goes towards the centre of the ground and finds Darren Smith. Smith plays on quickly, up towards full forward it goes. Thumped away by Tasker. Out towards the back pocket. Tasker going in again. In there is Foster. Stephen Riley. What will the umpire do? Holding the ball. Gee whiz. Holding the ball. Free kick. Taken by Barrett. Back towards centre wing it goes. And enforced out of play.
Yes, well, Port Adelaide very, and you can see a very, very happy little Port Adelaide supporter there, thinking to himself, in a couple of years, perhaps I could be out on the same arena. But Port Adelaide very sharp, very alert, very early in the game.
I agree with Ken. Some attention is needed on that holding the ball rule. They haven't quite got it right yet. Mayo gets it out. They lost it. Smallridge, he's gone. Clomp through, can't find it. getting Foster. Klomp again, well done. Gets it out. Jennifer with a run on the ball now on the left foot, but didn't get it far. Gee, Turner's down in there. They can't get it out clear. Riley meets it well. Out towards centre wing. Redden's looking for someone to give it to. They can't find it. Gee, Mayle finally gets it away. He's going to have to go in for it again. Still can't get it. No one can pick it up. Finally coming through now, Marshall gets it across. Here's a chance, Saliba puts it up towards full forward. Dittmar there with him, Delaney to the line. And that's where the ball will finish, left full forward pocket, North in attack.
Yes, well, Delaney, you can see a little supporter there, rugged up for the night. It's pretty warm down here. Not a lot of expression there, and obviously he's a little Port Adelaide supporter, but Delaney coming back from Fitzroy Cannon, he'd be very, very keen to do well and to keep Dittmar down to no score tonight.
You're right there, Rick. A big bonus for Port Adelaide as Parsons taps it over towards Noonan. It's stolen from that player. Jennifer with the football now. Back towards the centre of the ground. Looking out there for Darren Smith, who's played pretty well in the opening quarter. Takes the strong mark. Breaks away too easily. Over the top to Hutton. He dropped the football. Goes back in again. Gets it out towards Hughes. Hughes now with the bike shorts on. Over the top to Mark Williams. That's a sloppy handball. Tyler did it beautifully. Back to Mark Williams, who hooks it around his body. It'll lob in the square. Boyd is there, but it bounces the wrong way and through for a point.
Yes, well, Port Adelaide looked very, very sharp. I've mentioned it a couple of times, and on that occasion, Tyler, he could have gone flat out for the football, but he decided to palm it down to Mark Williams, and unfortunately, he couldn't finish the playoff.
Tasker gets a lead out, grandstand side. Thumped away there from Simmons, working hard. Perkins, Hutton, well done. Got the handball away. Shetry in the left full forward pocket. Worrying him all the way is former clubmate Jason Rowe. But the ball goes out of play in the left full forward pocket.
Yes, well, Setri, we know in the grand final last year, boys, that came onto the ground and did a fantastic job. Kicked a couple of goals. Hasn't been a regular member of the side, but certainly a very, very important member of the Port Adelaide side.
Port Adelaide by 18 points. Umpire Jeans has given a free kick here. It's going the way of Port Adelaide's Smith. I think it might have been against Michael Redden, although he's not having much of a serve of umpire Jeans, so maybe not. Third kick to Smith. He's 45 out when he kicks. Coming back with the boot. Brilliantly done.
Yes, well, it's really going to test Port Adelaide and especially young Turner tonight. Darren Smith, number 28, been training with the Crows. Very, very important player. Elusive. And you can see here on your screen that obviously Turner completely shepherded out Darren Smith. But a very, very good player, and it's going to really test young Turner tonight. He's been a very, very good player for North Adelaide, and he's met his match tonight in Darren Smith.
The bounce, Port 4-2, all over North Adelaide, 2 points. Chance for Marshall. He's well tackled on that occasion by Smallridge. Taken by Jennifer, the Port Adelaide machine going ahead again. Darren Smith's had a tremendous first quarter so far. With him as Ryan, breaks the tackle ever so easily. Don't tell me he's going to kick this. No, he's not. Right across the face of goal, still in play, bouncing towards the line and finally out of bounds.
Fantastic play there by Darren Smith, because under pressure, he had the ball by himself. But to think of the back screw, Ken, from a Port Adelaide player especially, that's sensational play.
Yes, out of play. Throw in. Boyd. Out to Smith. Turn of the spoiler, or endeavour to spoil it. Will go over the top to Tyler. Back to Smith. Smith, what will he do? He's hit the post. Well, he's certainly having a fine quarter on occasion. He hit the post.
Yeah, I mentioned a couple of seconds ago that Darren Smith playing on the half-forward flank. He's standing young Turner, who's been in sensational form for North Adelaide. But Darren Smith just making the space and making young Turner really check him tonight.
5 kicks, 2 handballs, 2-1 to Darren Smith. Fine first 14 minutes of the game as the boot ball comes back to Chalmers. Smallridge off the boot into the pocket, getting back underneath it quickly there is Ryan. With him is Boyd. The ball is punched out of play. Throw in on the left full forward pocket. Port Adelaide now by 25 points. Only played 14 minutes. A huge start. At the throw in, Redden. Over the top came Mark Williams, got the thump away, but only as far as Stephen Riley. He has nowhere to go, goes for the safety of the line, but it didn't eventuate, and he's lost it to a kick out of bounds on the full. Hutton from the half-forward left flank, waits for the lead of Tyler, going to put it up for grabs, going up towards Tyler. Smith lurking in the background, off the fingers it comes. Who's first there? Getting back Turner. Now it goes over to Klomp, the running player Tasker. North Adelaide out of defence, up towards centre wing. getting back on it there. Piazzi, beautifully done. Elects to play on, missed a handball. Northeast didn't read it too well. He's going to have to concede back to Rosonigo. They've lost 50 metres out of that, but the double play to Northeast in turn Smallridge, and Port Adelaide are underway again. Stephen Williams out towards his brother. Mark Williams, well done, half forward left flank. Can't score from there. Elects to play on for Tyler. Two on one in the square. Down they go. At the back of the pack, it is Tyler again. But he won't make the grade, and the ball is stumbled through for a point. But, gee, magnificent play for Port Adelaide.
Yes, well, Port Adelaide there, and you can see on your screen, beautiful mark there by the young fellow Williams, Mark Williams. But you didn't see on your screen, poor old Delaney, who's come back from Fitzroy, ran from fullback right down to get hold of a play. And that just shows the desperation of Port Adelaide tonight.
Perkins with the football, goes over the top to Tasker. Port Adelaide looking far the better side in this first quarter. Good players all over the ground, both in defence and attack. And North Adelaide skill level not as good as you would expect from a side coached by Michael Noonan. Off hands, players working hard, his mail around his body. Back towards half forward, Noonan and Fiachi having a bit of a battle there. Bennett, here's a chance now for North Adelaide through Simmons. Simmons short. And Saliba marks outside 50. Over the top to Noonan. Coming out there is also Dittmar. He marks. Dittmar. Should kick from here. Should kick it from here. He's no more than 25 metres directly in front.
Yes, we saw last week against South Adelaide. The only way to stop North Adelaide, you can see there in your screen. Beautiful mark by Dittmar. Oh, a little bit of attention there by George. But it's up to Michael Dittmar, who missed a number of plays last week, to finish off, if he can sort of surely finish off tonight.
His first possession for the evening, and North barely need a goal. He kicks, and he has, what's he done? He's missed. North Adelaide 3 points, Port Adelaide 4-4.
Yes, well, there you can see the big fella in your screen come across from Port Adelaide after a little bit of discrepancy or discontentment there, and they're the sort of plays, especially tonight, that he should finish off.
Rick, I reckon they should have 3 goals. They've only had a few opportunities, but the ones that they've had have been fairly simple. Not to worry, it's going to be Foster with the ball on the half back line for Port Adelaide. Runs it over now to Rosonico. Didn't gain a great deal, except the double play came back to Foster. Kicks long now to the half forward line. Up there is Smith. He's got the run of the football now. Turner giving chase. Smith through the half forward line. Gee, should have been shepherded then by Ginnivan. Turner comes out with a football. Back now to Saliba. He'll come across tack. Finds short now, it is Perkins. Perkins at centre half back, puts it out wide. No, he's not. He thought about giving it to Tasker. Tasker up from fullback. Now he gets a lead into the half forward line. That's beautifully put. Back towards Josh Marley's lost it. Needs support from there. Going through is Marshall. 45 metres out. On the lead is Dittmar, and that's well put.
Well, there's nothing like North Adelaide going forward, especially when everybody in the stand, all the supporters think, oh, there's nowhere to kick it. They wait and wait and wait and just make sure that somebody makes it a little bit of space, and then they try and get the ball to him.
Dittmar from Campbell's corner. Kick from about 40, I would think. Perhaps if he just takes the left goal post, he'll be right. Oh, that is a magnificent kick, Dittmar. And that is North Adelaide's first goal.
Yeah, well, what a magnificent goal there by Dittmar. He misses one from about 30 metres out. And then all of a sudden he gets into Campbell's graveyard, as we call it. I know he's a left footer, and you can see him in your screen, number 20. Enormous amount of ability. He really is a player of the future. He's about 6'5". He can take a mark, but so many times he lets you down on the take of the ball and the finish-off play.
Back with umpire Steve Semler. Port Adelaide 4-4, North Adelaide 1-3. That was their first goal. Down goes young Noonan with a heavy hip and shoulder bump. Saliba got quick hands. Smallridge. Saunders. Barrett up towards full forward. Dittmar, good kick and a good mark.
Well, it's very early in the game and Dittmar's had a couple of shots. But the big fella there, Delaney, would be thinking, it's a long way to come back from Fitzroy. And this bloke's getting in front. And you can see there on your screen, North Adelaide, we all know that they can really place the ball, and a very good mark. And let's hope he can finish the play off.
North Adelaide need this one badly. It's a lot easier than the last one he kicked. 25 metres from goal on a 45-degree angle, going to the golf course end, and he has drilled his second goal.
Yes, well, there you see the goal umpire straight over the top of his head, and Dittmar, we know what he can do, and you can see Barrett pushing the ball forward, and Dittmar, exactly like a full forward should be, in front and taking a mark, a very solid mark there. Delaney, he's had a couple of kicks in the last couple of minutes, and a beautiful rhythm too, coming in. And they're the type of goals, obviously, boys, that you must finish off.
Barrett, Klomp, and also Young Turner off the half back line, starting to give North Adelaide a few opportunities. At the bounce, it's Port Adelaide by 13 points. Parsons in ruck, comes out with a football, heaves it out, going through Perkins, straight body, did it well, flips it over Barrett, here's a chance, Saliba 45 metres out, heads for goal, and he's well offline. The youngster's had two excellent opportunities to kick goals, he has blown them both.
Yes, well, KG's very excited here in the box, and so he should be, because North Adelaide, a beautiful bit of movement there, and Saliba, Michael Noonan would be very, very keen, a player of his ability to finish off that play.
Yes, best man on the ground, in my opinion, in the first quarter. Nine possessions, oh, poor bit of work there by Fiachi, kicks into the man on the mark. Now a chance for North Adelaide through Bennett. Bennett, did he go out of play? No, he didn't. He did, but the ball didn't, which is the important thing. Up towards Dittmar. Ducked his head at the critical stage. Phillips comes in, taps the ball towards the line, and it goes out of play.
Yes, well, that was a little bit disappointing there on Dittmar. The ball came in pretty quickly, and you can see there on your screen.
Yes, of course, tomorrow night, 10 minutes past 11. It's a beauty. The one-day international live from Trinidad, Australia versus the West Indies. As we see Fiachi now, brings the ball out towards Rozonico. Rozonico from the half-back flank, back towards centre wing. Thumped away by Young Turner. Chance for Hutton. Hutton tackled, a hurry kick up towards Stephen Williams. Smallridge ducked ahead. Chippy Ping almost holding the ball. In there was Marshall working hard, and the ball is being held to a pack of players, and umpire Semler will bounce.
Well, this is a great bit of a great game of football, because Port Adelaide jumped out of the boxes like a greyhound, and Port Adelaide scoring three goals, but North Adelaide getting back into this game by being desperate and by making the handballs hit the body.
Into time on first quarter. Well done, Ginever. Didn't get a great deal of distance with it. Klomp under pressure. Saliba again tried to throw it out. Ginever got it to the half forward line. Back in defence is Saunders. Kicks back high towards centre wing. The leap is on. Here's a chance now for Parsons, gets it out, the running power is Bennett, on the right foot, goes in towards Redden, going to be cut off at the pass, gets it out to Foster, he's under pressure from Redden, in they go now towards centre wing, Marshall with a chance, has to beat one, two, gets it out, no one home for North Adelaide, Abernethy can't find the bounce, there with him now is Saunders, slips out the handball, Fiachi through, gives it away, Rozonico, the runner out the outer side is Delaney. Port Adelaide through the centre line, head into attack. Tyler wants it in long, he's in the square, got to have to get the kick away. Kicked into the mound. Sentry's going to have to get them out of it, but they're going to lose it through Ryan. Overdid the play and they've lost the football.
Away to Turner. North Adelaide running the ball beautifully out of defence through Tasker, back towards centre wing. Oh, great bit of work by Bennett. Strike me, pink umpire, let that go. Two players contesting the football and he pays a free kick.
Yes, well, a little bit of bad luck there, because you can see Bennett trying to find the front spot, but it was very interesting there, Delaney. Over in Victoria, Ken, obviously we're a little bit quicker over here.
Russell Boyd now with a chance for Port Adelaide. Can't do much with the football. Picked up by Noonan. His handball is loose. Back towards Stephen Williams from outside the 50. Centres the football up towards full court. Almost a great mark to Tyler. In there was Parsons. Satchi's with him, and umpire Sandler will call for a bounce. Well, Rick, I don't know how you saw that free kick against Bennett, but to me there were two players vying for the ball. They'll both hang on to each other, let it go.
Well, you can see Mike Noonan there. He's a little bit keen because the jumped out of the box, Port Adelaide. But don't worry about the umpires, Ken. Let's worry about the game. North Adelaide are getting in after the football. They're trying to find front spot, and I think that's the difference that's come over this game.
Ken, I wouldn't be surprised if the runner went out and just gave the umpire a serve then, because he didn't talk to any North Adelaide player. Now he's going back past the same umpire and he's had another few words. And Michael Noonan, as you can see in your nine screen there, was a far from happy coach after that last incident Ken was talking about. Turner, Saliba, siren sounds, and it's Port Adelaide by 12 points.
Yes, well, Port Adelaide jumped out of the box, as I said, a couple of minutes ago, but North Adelaide coming back in, getting the front spot. You can see there on your screen, Michael Noonan, a little bit upset with the umpires, but I wouldn't worry about that. They're back in this game, they're getting in front spot, and to kick a couple of goals is a good start.
It's Peter Bennett on your screen, so it's quarter time. It's Port Adelaide 4-4-28, leading North Adelaide 2-4-16. A great game of football, and you're seeing it live on Nine's Wide World of Sports.
Welcome back to Football Park at quarter time. An excellent game of football. Port Adelaide 4-4-28. Lead North Adelaide 2-4-16. And the main goal scorers for Port Adelaide, Smith 2, Setri and Boyd 1 apiece. And for North Adelaide, Dittmar 2 at full forward. A great first quarter. Let's now take you back for the start of the all-important second quarter. Your commentator is Ian Day.
Thanks, Ken. 12 points the difference. Port Adelaide in front. Siren sounds. Game underway in the second quarter. Just a smidgen of breeze now starting to blow here at Football Park, and I'm certain the players will be happy about it. Smallridge off the left foot. He got it from Mark Williams. Up high towards the half forward line. Over the top went Hughes. Cleverly tapped it out. Stephen Williams on the left leg. Grubbers one in. Here's a chance now for Abernethy. He lost it. Tyler's got it. Lost it. In they go hard for the football. What's the umpire going to do after all this? No holding the ball decision, despite the fact that Jason Rowe thought he should. There you can see a breeze just creeping up a little bit. And, of course, North Adelaide kicking with it in this quarter. I don't think it's going to have a huge effect on the game for certain. Thumped away by Hughes. In towards the forward pocket. Getting back on it is Tasker. With him, Tyler. Been well held up to date. But the ball is tapped out of play for a throw-in. Right forward pocket, Port Adelaide.
Yes, I think you'll find, you can see Johnny Cale there up, having a bit of a discussion with Gary Treadray on the right-hand side there with his glasses. They'd be pretty happy, but North Adelaide got right back into it in the first quarter.
The throw-in. Port Adelaide into attack. Stolen by Mark Williams around his body toward full four. Doesn't cover much territory. Offhand it goes the way of Klomp. Klomp thought about the handball, then finally goes the way of Bradley Ryan. Bradley Ryan pretty quick, uses his pace, bounds away, has his second bounce, kicks up towards half forward, Noonan Fiachi. And Fiachi, very experienced, thumps the ball away.
Yes, well, it's going to be a great education for the young fella there, the coach's son, Timmy Noonan, on George Fiachi. He'd be looking a bit disappointed, I suppose, being discarded by the Crows. With Roger Delaney back, Ken, he'd be very, very keen to do well.
Too right he would. Parsons takes the football. The kick is smothered. Foster. Hutton works hard over the top, taken by Marshall. Back to Barrett. Saliba, terrific first quarter. To Mayo. Thought about the try to get it back towards Marshall and Saliba, but a good tackle by Smallridge finds the North Adelaide player hot on the ball. Smallridge plays on quickly, goes beautifully towards Hughes at centre half forward. He takes the mark, plays on quickly around his body, puts it out towards Paul Northeast. Northeast in there, has a fit of the fumbles, being harassed by Simmons, who's doing a pretty good job. Does it well, Simmons. Does it superbly. Riley back towards young Turner. Turner out towards Jason Rowe. Rowe from centre wing puts it up towards half forward. Off hands it goes. Rosonico is in there and the ball towards the line. In fact, it's still in play. And finally, Rosonico pushes it out.
Yes, well, very good work there by North Adelaide when the ball went. And you can see there the brains trust of the Crows. Of course, they're on the right-hand side, Bobby Hammond. And, of course, they're playing with his teeth as the coach, Graham Corns. And they'd be anxiously looking at the players performing tonight. And, of course, Darren Smith, I suppose. Very, very good first quarter, Ken, and he'd come up for selection.
Rosonico trying to get it across there to Fost, and the ball tumbles out of play. Behind the hierarchy was General Manager Bill Sanders. And the Crows doing it OK at the moment. Graham Corns almost looked relaxed. Throw in the left full forward pocket. North Adelaide in attack, leading by, or down by 12 points. A goal would come in handy right here. Parsons at the back. Chalmers gets the tap away. Mail in hard against the tide. Simmons has the football, lost the football. And the umpire said it's out of play once more. Crowd building. I would think over 7,000 people here tonight. And that's a fine sign. But then again, Port Adelaide is playing.
Yes, whether you love them or you hate them. They certainly have got the following. Noonan, taken on that occasion by Grimm. Handball is smothered. Back towards Setri. In fact, it's Rosonico. And the ball out of play.
Yes, well, Port Adelaide and North Adelaide. Very even first quarter, apart from the first 10 minutes. And it's going to be very, very interesting to see which team, either Port Adelaide or North Adelaide, can get on top here and kick a couple of goals.
Parsons. Over towards Josh Mail. Here's a race in pace. Getting there is Barrett. Needs support. Fiachi, Saliba, Smallridge. Getting back on it is Noonan. And just kicks high wide. Not very handsome, but manages 1 point. Takes North Adelaide on to 2-5 now. Port is 4-4.
I mentioned a couple of seconds ago, Georgie Porgie, the back pocket specialist. Young Timmy Noonan there. Brilliant little player. I think he's got an enormous future. Very quick with his hands. But on that occasion, he was a bit of struggle.
Delaney now bring the ball back into play for the Magpies. Isn't too many options. Go short to Smallridge and he marks. over to Rosonico. He's the running player. Back towards Phillips. Phillips comes towards centre wing. Not a good kick by the big man. Chance for Saunders. He ran past the football. Hutton goes in, but the ball in the interim is out of play. Centre wing, grandstand side.
Again, very interesting, Port Adelaide. Then they have the opportunity to go straight down the ground, and they just seem to force the ball over to this banner. There's not too much breeze about. I would have thought that would have been better served going straight down the ground.
Comment Jumbo Prince, taken by Mark Williams. Handballs to his brother, Stephen. Stephen Wall shepherded by Smallridge towards half forward, and it's Abernethy. Abernethy. Kick number two towards centre-half forward. Off-hands it goes. Setray in there. Over the football, taps it out. Saliba goes in. In fact, he tapped it out too late, and it's holding the ball, and the free kick will be taken by Perkins.
Perkins at centre-half, back for the Roosters. Kick number four. Out wide to centre wing. In there was Bennett, couldn't get it out. Marshall gave a chance to Mayo. Mayo puts it out wide. Half forward line, out comes Parsons. Couldn't manage it. Biachi back at centre-half back. Tries to get Phillips to help him. The big fellow can't get there. Here's a chance, Bennett. Bennett on the wrong foot, goes back. Going to get collared. Great tackle there by Grimm. Now it's Phillips. He doesn't want to kick the ball. Got the handball away. Stephen Williams gets it out wide. Brilliantly done. Jennifer gets it through. Smallridge on the left leg. The kick is a shocker. And it's Perkins. Back at centre half, back out wide to Riley. Riley's got no one to kick to. He's going to have to go very long out looking for Simmons. He won't make the grade. In the end, he has to go for the safety of the line. Although Foster beats him to him, or beats him to it. Goes in short half forward line. Hutton on the left leg, goes in towards the half forward line. Smith with a chance. Once again, couldn't handle it. Turner, Smith gets rid of the ball. Going through now, Rosonico. Rosetri it is, goes back in short. Here's a chance. Hutton from 40 metres has a flying shot, but he's offline. In fact, it's out of play on the full.
Yes, well, fantastic football there by Port Adelaide. Moving the ball around. North Adelaide really tackling hard. And I mentioned a couple of minutes ago, South Adelaide, the only reason they could beat North Adelaide was stop that quick movement of the football. And Port Adelaide are doing just that tonight.
Bradley Ryan with the action now. Port into attack. Kick number three for Bradley Ryan. Back towards the half-back flank. Smith appeared to get a push out in the back. Not paid. Smallridge in there. Weaves his way out of trouble. Back onto the left boot towards the back pocket. But the mark has been taken by a mile. Has blistering speed. He's in real stripe out there. And in fact, it's gone out of play. He's got some pace, the youngster, that's for sure.
And Ken, that's why you've got reverse in the car, isn't it? Because Shirley put it right in it.
You're right there, Jumbo. Clomp. Now they're moving it out. Turner, he's in stripe. Took a long time to get rid of that. Back to Mayo. Back to Saliba. Tremendous first quarter. Goes short in towards Bennett. He's hassled by Phillips. Over to Mark Williams. Mark Williams, a long kick. Back towards centre half forward. Thumped away on that occasion by Ryan, but a free kick has been seen. It'll go North Adelaide's way. And the big man, Redden, on the bottom of the pack.
Michael Redden. First kick, if he does, kicks it out wide towards the half-forward line. Coming to meet it is Bennett over the top. He's got the football, gets it back to Saunders in turn. Here's a chance, Clomp. Got a right, or he crashes that tackle, gets out a handball. That is a shocking handball. It's kicked around the corner by Abernethy, up towards the half-forward line. Riley off the pack. Riley now will come out wide. Perkins has got a chance to take it home. He needs to sit. Oh, under pressure now. Can't find it, runs into trouble. Under pressure, Saunders can't find it. On hands and knees goes after it. Foster with a chance. Took the high tackle. Stephen Williams thought about Boyd. Puts it up. Oh, Setri a million miles clear. Gives it away to Hughes. 30 metres out. Goes in. Tyler on his own. Lay down, Mazzia. Cannot miss.
Well, Port Adelaide. Oh, you see them at their best. Last year, the grand finalists and premiers. They move the ball forward. And you can see here Foster. Very, very easy play, and you can see there Stephen Williams looking down the ground, not blasting. And there he is, little Setri, standing out. And there's Hughes popping the ball over to number 24 on your screen. And there he is, Tyler, putting through another goal.
Port Adelaide 5-4-34, lead North Adelaide 2-5-17. Foundation Cup round five. But a very entertaining game of football. 9.5 minutes into the second quarter. The bounce favours Redden. Young Grimm comes in. Marshall to Perkins. Perkins around his body. Hutton with an opportunity. Barrett with him. He's gets a beautiful bounce out towards Marshall. He lost the football. Perkins again. They've still got an opportunity, North Adelaide. Barrett now. The second chance. Goes short towards half forward. And a good mark to Klomp. Klomp plays on quickly. Through half forward he goes. Into the pocket looking for Dittmar, but he's found Rizonico instead. Rizonico back to Delaney. The Port Adelaide defence comes back towards the grandstand side. A great kick by Delaney. Finds Fiacci. Fiacci plays on quickly. You'll hear that a lot of times in the coming year. Delaney to Fiacci. Into the centre of the ground it goes. Smith, a long handball out to Smallridge. Beautiful movement, Port Adelaide. Smallridge over towards Tyler. The kick is too long. Stephen Riley in there. Played pretty well. In fact, it was Ryan. Ryan now back to Tasker. Tasker with a chance now with a searching handball. Gets to Klopp. Good movement by both sides. Over to Noonan. Will he get a free kick down the ground? He should have. Up towards full forward. It goes off hands. Working hard there was Grimm. Under the youngster. Did that well, Grimm. Back towards centre wing. Out towards Hutton. Hutton with a chance now. We'll put the Maggies into attack. Out of sight. Up towards half forward he goes. Looking for Tyler. Uses the body well and takes a strong mark, Tyler.
Yes, well, they say our football's going to lack a little bit of quality this year, but you can't get any better football than that. You can see there, Tyler, number 24, getting in front, taking a one-grab mark, and a beautiful bit of play there by Port Adelaide.
55 metres out. His second kick, first one produced a goal. Won't make the distance. Turner back, Redden in front, Smith over the top, Boyd! Boyd kicks his second.
Yes, well, there, well, you can see Russell Boyd, number 35 in your screen, sitting at the back. Beautiful movement there by Port Adelaide. Tipsy-turvy, up and down the ground, but a beautiful mark by Tully. You can see there, number 28 in your screen in Smith, went up for the mark, but waiting down was Russell Boyd and took the opportunity and put through Port Adelaide's sixth goal.
Port Adelaide have a grip on the game now. 6-4, North 2-5. Redden in the middle against Grimm. Redden with a tap. Rowe went without the football. Setre's in there. Abernethy. Heavy body work in the square. Oh, in went Smallridge. Works like a tiger to get the football. Has the ball held to him, and umpire Samuel will call for a bounce.
Well, Ken, when you're looking at me, you can see a very anxious, I suppose, Port Adelaide supporter.
How does she know what she's knitting there? She's looking at the footing and knitting. How do you do that, Rick?
Well, a pair of socks comes pretty easy, Ken.
Back of socks.
I suppose you know about knitting, Rick.
Oh, comment Ian Day. Taken by Perkins. Perkins towards half forward. Rizonico in defence for Port Adelaide. Has plenty of time. This way, that way. He gets himself into trouble. Finally gives it to North, to Northeast. And in fact, a relayed free kick against against Mick Redden. Taken by Stephen Williams. In the centre of the ground. Out towards half forward. And Darren Smith takes the mark. Over the top to Mark Williams. Port Adelaide, the better looking side at the moment. Up towards full forward and through from one to score.
Yes, well, you're certainly right there, Ken. Port Adelaide really look aggressive up forward. They've got Tyler, not that he's doing a lot, but they've all over the ground, especially Mark Williams. Darren Smith's on fire on the half forward flank, and they really look a combination at the moment.
Tasker, grandstand side, passes, gives the lead, sets himself, can't find it. Darren Smith's at the back, has the football. Well done, back to Abba. Abba puts it up for grabs, out steams Tyler. Getting back on the ball is Boyd. Mark Williams through, gives it back. Ginever around the corner in towards the pocket, getting in there quickly now was Tyler. Tyler's lost it, gives it away. Setre against the tide. Smith, Tetri again on the left leg, shoots and goes.
Yes, well, a magnificent bit of play there by Port Adelaide. They've been really raking up to a goal, and there you can see the little fella. Magnificent performance last year. Tyler working hard, very, very keen not to keep the ball in under it. You can see Hughes bursting through at centre half forward. Little Setre, the opportunist that he is, moved in, swooped on the ball, and a beautiful left foot. You can see him, eyes on the footy, around the North Adelaide players. There up goes the right-hand fist to say, you beauty.
Port Adelaide 7-5, North 2-5. Port have taken a grip on this game. Klomp works hard for it. Also Parsons. Got a free kick for a throw or holding the ball. It'll go Port Adelaide's way. In fact, it's Chalmers. Chalmers up towards centre-half forward. Parsons, Smith, Mark Williams in there. North Adelaide working hard. It's stolen by Ginova into a pack of players, and umpire Jeff Jeans will bounce outside the 50. 14 and a half minutes gone, second quarter, and Port in control. 7-5, North 2-5. North Adelaide's game has fallen completely apart at the moment. Players working hard. Smith appeals for holding the ball. Will he get it? No, he won't. Canteen Kids, and of course every Coke you buy tonight will go towards that marvellous organisation, the Canteen. It's Kiddies with Cancer, certainly a wonderful cause. So if you're here tonight, certainly dip in the pocket and buy a drink of Coke. Mark Williams at half forward with possession now. Reeves passed, goes up towards full forward, looking for Tyler. Will it carry? Oh, it's a great mark to Mark Tyler.
Beautiful movement there by Port Adelaide. They're completely on top of the forward lines, and you can see Mark Williams putting the ball. He didn't just blast the ball up into the centre of the ground. He just made sure that Tyler had a bit of movement to go forward, and a beautiful place to kick.
Certainly was, and Mark Tyler now. Kick number three. Kicking for his second goal. It's a long kick. It'll get the distance, but just a little offline, and Port 7-6 lead North Adelaide 2-5.
Yes, well, a very good mark there, boys, and just unfortunate. I think that's going to be his trouble. Number 24, he's 6 foot three or four, beautiful mover, good mark, but he's just got to finish off those easy plays from about 30 metres out.
He's got some big shoes to fill, Rick, but no doubt the boy's got talent. Chalmers over the top. Marshall got it out, but not effectively. Mark Williams back now to Brett Chalmers, high now towards the half forward line. And there it's almost taken by Redden. Perkins back in defence. Out comes Noonan, gets the ball out wide. It's all Port Adelaide. Piachi getting back on the half back line. Got the city was looking for. The running player now is Chalmers. Chalmers all puts Smallridge. Had to get rid of it like a hot new brick. Under pressure once again. Now is Ginova, and it's kicked away by Chalmers. Fiachi got it to Chalmers. Bit of a push in the back from Russell Boyd. I think he knew it as soon as the umpire blew the whistle. And the free kick will go to Bradley Ryan on the half back line.
Isn't it amazing, Daisy? As soon as he pushed him in the back, he knew that he'd done it and gave the ball back straight away.
Reminded me of Rick Davies' little push, that one, Rick. Fiachi getting back in defence. Delaney well played to fend off the running player there in Dittmar. Out wide, it is northeast. He will get it over to Smallridge. Port Adelaide into attack. The running player, Foster, through the centre line. Out goes Tyler towards the half forward line. Not well put. And Jason Rowe takes a fine mark in defence on the half back line.
Mail off and Atkinson on for North Adelaide. Good mark on that occasion by Rowe. Came from Port Adelaide to North Adelaide. Kick number three. And a 50-metre penalty kick will go against Danny Hughes. Not good discipline on that occasion by the former Melbourne player.
Ken, I thought he gave the umpire a Churchillian gesture there. He might have got 100.
Daisy, you were right. He did give him the gesture. The action with Jason Rowe towards centre-half forward it goes. Rosonico's there, so is Redden. Here's a chance now for Dittmar. It's it for him. Kicks towards goal, and he's wobbled it through. Goal to North Adelaide.
Yes, well, North Adelaide, they're not in this game at the moment. Port Adelaide have been completely dominant up forward. A couple of times that North Adelaide have gone forward, and you can see there Redden didn't really get off the ground. Came over the top of the pack, and you can see there were Dittmar swooped on the ball, and a beautiful left foot kick. And I think that you'll find that they may need a little bit more of that. You can see him just taking a bit of a drink down there. Delaney doing a pretty good job.
Dittmar has kicked all of North Adelaide's goals. It's 7-6 to 3-5. We've played 18 minutes of the second quarter. The ball forced towards the half forward line by Klomp. Atkins come onto the field, doing it well towards the half forward line, but he can't pick it up. And it goes out of play on the half forward right flank. You recall North's resurgence against South Adelaide was brought about by this young man. Four kicks, seven handballs and two goals when he came onto the ground towards the end of the third quarter. Added a lot of bite to the North Adelaide attacking division. Klomp can't get out, and the umpire will have to come and ball it up on the half forward right flank. 7-6, plays 3-5. Bounce just outside the 50 metre line. Bennett, the bodies go in. Bennett gets the tap. Saliba looks for the handball, can't find it. Likewise, Chalmers back there. Smallbridge through, did that one well to Hutton, centre wing. Port Adelaide into attack now, up towards the half forward line. Smith out on his lonesome, lost the football, which he should have had. The umpire said play on. and quickly it's thumped back by Parsons, high to the half forward line. Up they fly, Barrett through, did it well, lost it now, getting it Atkinson, Saliba on the fly again, Dittmar on the lead, he's lost it. Here's a chance now, Noonan across to Saliba, puts it out, brilliantly done, open goal, and it is Turner that goes through and kicks his first.
Yes, well, magnificent play there by North Adelaide. I thought they were in all sorts of trouble there up the ground, but there you've got young Saliba, beautiful movement, always looking further forward, and you've got Dittmar going to ground, beautiful work there by Noonan, back to Saliba, and over the top to Dittmar, and... Well, I didn't think Dittmar had been doing too much, Ken, but obviously he's kicked their only four goals and he's very prominent up forward.
Well, a valuable goal to North Adelaide. They still trail Port 7-6 to 4-5, but a good goal to Dittmar. He's kicked four now, back in the centre, taken by Smallridge, who's in control in the middle against Klomp. Players want possession desperately, but umpire Jeff Jean says it's my footy.
Yes, Ken Smallridge is a very important player and very impressive player. Left footer, looks a little bit like the other Port Adelaide player in Brown, but he's completely controlling centre at this particular point in time.
Yes, his second good performance with Port Adelaide. A free kick will go the way of Danny Hughes. He should be an asset for the Maggies too, back from a stint with Melbourne in the AFL. Up towards centre half forward it goes. Tyler coming out, thumped away by Tasker. In there goes young Hart. Hart the handball away to Turner. Two promising youngsters. He's run down by Darren Smith. Stolen by Atkinson. Back to Tasker. He won't be run down. He's got plenty of speed, but kicks poorly. And the mark has been taken by Chalmers. Another promising youngster for the Magpies. Chalmers into the middle of the ground. Looking out there for Mark Williams. The ball came from Saliba. Smallridge again towards half forward. Rowe with an opportunity. Rowe has three North Adelaide players there, but kick shocking. Right, that was a terrible kick. He had three North Adelaide players at centre wing where he should have kicked to, and kicked out of bounds on the full.
Yes, Ken, well, I suppose you could see that he didn't have any player up forward to kick to, and he thought he'd go for the boundary. Unfortunately, it was just a bad kick.
Mark Williams from Hutton, well tackled. Saliba gets it back now to Hughes. Hooks around the corner, out comes Tyler, gets the set, needs support from there, hooks it back, here's a chance now for Jennifer, charges a football, lose it there now, Klomp gets it out, quickly Perkins, Barrett, the running player is Ryan, through the half back line, Atkinson goes long now, half forward line, out steams Big Michael, lost it, Simmons, under pressure, Redden gets it back again, he's under pressure, lost the football, the umpire said he could play on, Rosonico back to Fiacci, in turn he'll give it across, and the running player is Foster. Oh, Port Adelaide got open slather here, Hutton now from centre wing, puts it on its way quickly, coming across is Turner, and takes the easy defensive mark, he needs support, gets it out on the outer side from Stephen Riley. He'll go in short, centre wing, Bennett at centre wing to send the Roosters into attack. Looks for Dittmar on the lead, doesn't look at all like Turner to me. Called him that, must apologise. Fiacci through on the left leg. Puts it out wide towards centre wing, making a metre as Smith. Can't get there and the ball will beat him out of play.
Yes, when you can see there, Port Adelaide looking very sharp indeed.
Tomorrow night, 10 minutes past 11, I'll be glued to my television set. The one-day international, the second one, live from Trinidad, the Aussies versus the Windies, and put your money on the Aussies. That's on Nine's Wide World of Sports. At centre wing, taken by Darren Smith. Back to Smallridge, gee whiz, he works hard, this young man. Up towards full 40 goes, a beautiful lead by Tylor, and put well in by Smallridge. Williams now, that's Stephen Williams, around his body, back towards Danny Hughes. Didn't take the mark. Bradley Ryan, north of the chance now to work it out of defence. Over to Noonan. Noonan had good vision. Saw two North Adelaide players loose. He goes the way of Bennett. Now here's a chance, but there's the siren. So at half-time, it's Port Adelaide by 20 points.
Yes, well, North Adelaide certainly in the first quarter and the end of that quarter really came back into the game. But Port Adelaide just in front. They're staying there. They're playing in front. Very, very aggressive at the ball. And they've got the points, especially with Mark Williams there playing well.
At half-time, Port is 7-6, North 5. A 4-5, Friday Night Football, live on Nine's Wide World of Sports.
Welcome back to Football Park. Quarter time was Port Adelaide 4-4-28, North Adelaide 2-4-16. And at half time, Port Adelaide still in front, the Maggies 7-6-48, North Adelaide 4-5.
Yeah, great game of footy. The Magpies, Smith, Boyd, and Setri 2 and Tyler 1. And for the Roosters, Dittmar 4, looking very good up forward.
Well, he certainly played a lone hand, Rick, isn't he, up forward?
He certainly has. He doesn't look as though he's getting too many kicks, but he's kicked four goals and could have had a couple more, Ken.
Exactly. Well, the early game tonight, of course, Jumbo, was between Norwood and Sturt. And Norwood were a very, very impressive unit tonight, played particularly well. And there you see that Norwood led at every break. 4-2 to 1-1 at quarter time. Half time, 6-7-1-4. And the game was over then. 10-11 at 4-5 at three-quarter time. And the final result there, 12-13-85, Sturt 7-5-47.
Yes, it certainly was. And the goal kickers there, Payne, Thomas and Muster 2. And, of course, for the Blue Boys, O'Keefe with 2.
And I thought from Norwood's point of view, Rick, young Mellor and Thompson showed a great deal of promise.
Number 30, left-footer, ruckman.
Yep.
A couple of weeks ago we mentioned against Redden.
Yep.
Ordinary early, yes. And all of a sudden he started to jump like a bit of a jack-in-the-box. Yeah. And tonight I thought he followed on, and with young John Hall, he's a very exciting prospect.
They're going to be a very good side, Norwood, in season 1991. We're talking about good prospects and good fellows. Here's Graham Campbell.
Oh, thank you for that, Ken. I have erstwhile utility player Stephen Sims with me, one of the characters of the North Adelaide team. Not playing tonight, Steve, any reason for that?
I got a bit of a crook back, actually, Graham. Yeah, keep me out for a couple of weeks.
Hasn't been publicised. I mean, I think it goes hand in hand with this Adelaide team that the local competition really hasn't got the publicity for the injuries that people get. Normally that would be headlines. Stephen Sims injured.
Yeah, well, usually the news used to have a stop press area, but they don't have it anymore, so that's probably going to get a mention.
And, Steve, how long could you be out with it?
Probably, I'm hoping to play the first, I call the proper games, and if not, the second one.
And I've got to say this, you've looked fitter and trimmer than you have been for a long time at the first couple of games.
Yeah, I've had a pretty injury-free pre-season, so that helped, which I haven't had before. So.
Right, but now it's delayed, temporarily.
Yeah, it's just a stupid injury, which anyone could probably get, and I've got it.
So let's talk about the coming season. North haven't been hard hit by the Crows, have they, really, in the true sense of the word, in comparison to, say, a Norwood or a Glenelg?
No.
You've lost Hart.
Yeah, we lost Darryl and Darren, which are two pretty good players,
yep.
But we haven't been too bad off considering that.
And Trevor Clisby could get more than a few games, I guess.
Yeah, Clisby's going to be up there. He's working hard with the Crows, but he's some chance of being back with us. So.
Yeah. Now, having said that, Peter Bennett defected from the Crows, as did Adam Saliba. I thought that took a lot of, character for both players to turn their back on being potential AFL players.
Yeah, I think with Peter's was a lot more to his job than it was actually not wanting to play. Yeah, he's got a pretty good job, and I don't think he'd afford the time off, so that was his problem.
With Saliba?
Adam's probably a bit young, and he's got a bit to learn about football at the moment, so he thought that probably the pressure would be too much, so he's come back, and he's out here trying to learn.
I tend to agree with that. I think his game tonight has been spot on. I think he's been your best player so far. First quarter particularly.
He gets the ball a bit, but it's the things he's doing with it at the moment. Like, he had two easy shots for goal, which should have been two goals, and he missed both of them. So, coach wouldn't be happy, but you might be.
Well, you're in with a silly chance tonight, Steve, aren't you, really? You've come back from the dead twice.
Yeah, twice we looked down and out, but they've come back well, you know. I get the feeling sometimes they're umpiring like basketball sometimes, and other times they're umpiring like football, but...
Well, Steve, I'll say this. I've been told to cut it short now. They're going to interview somebody else now. I think it's Russell Johnson coming up. So good luck to you for the season, particularly.
Don't forget our show on
Sunday.
Oh, sorry,
there's a show coming on for North Adelaide. Sorry about that.
At the Dover Castle, 11 o'clock, gentlemen's morning. So no doubt I'll be there.
What does that mean?
Just gentlemen only.
Oh, right, fine. Thank you, Steve.
Okay, thanks a lot.
That's Graham Campbell talking to Stephen Sims, certainly a colourful character, and looks a lot fitter this year, Stephen Sims, and no doubt in for a big year for North Adelaide. Well, North Adelaide certainly have the job in front of them coming up in the second half against Port Adelaide. And just a reminder, of course, tomorrow night at 5:30, the KG Footy Show, and our special guest, the new Tigers coach and a likeable young man, Kim Hodgman. We'll come back with more footy from headquarters shortly. Welcome back to Football Park. Joining me now, Graham Campbell. Graham, a good second quarter by Port Adelaide.
Well, it was, Ken. They took over their first 15 minutes of play. In fact, it was all Port.
Yep.
But to North's credit, as I said to Stephen, they've come back from the dead twice. First quarter, they were getting run over. They kicked into a bit of a breeze, but Port didn't worry about the breeze at all. They had it all their own way the first 15 minutes. But North came back side of it surely. A bit of character being shown by the North youngsters.
And looking at the full forwards, of course, Graham, Dipmas kicked four. Yep. Tyler only one goal tonight.
Yes, Tyler's been a bit, well covered by Tasker back there. He has been really worn like a second skin more times than not. There's a left-hand hand pass from Chetre. And, of course, that's his one goal into the square. And well, I'm glad he didn't kick it out of the ground, as some blokes are prone to do. It annoys me, that. Other players set the goal up, and the player goes bang, kicks it out of the ballpark, and it takes half an hour to get the ball back. In the meantime, the players go cold.
And, Graham, a player who's been trying to win a permanent place in the Port Adelaide side now for a number of years is Russell Borden, and he might just do it this year.
Well, I think he should, Ken. He's a lively player, young Russell. Plays out of a forward pocket, which is a luxury role, really. You know, just playing down there, not getting a run on the ball ever. And he's got to make the most of his chances when the ball comes in. Gee whiz, that was a bit of a tit-for-tat there. That was Tyler again, of course, getting a free kick or a mark. And in they come. Russell Boyd, opportunist, left-foot goal. That's his second for the match. Kicked one in the first quarter. But that's what he's got to do, Ken. Pick up the falling ball and pop it through.
And young Setra, of course, was the hero of Port Adelaide's win in the grand final last year. Ever seen his game tonight?
Well, he's a lively player again. And he's very noticeable, Ken, with the fair hair. So you tend to notice those fair-haired blokes. It's a lot more than you do the blokes with just the normal short back and sides. There he is again, picking up the ball, popping it through. He is an opportunist also. A player of some quality, Setra, I believe, Ken. And will certainly be second rover this year to Tim Ginniver. Early doors anyhow. Wayne Marnie taking a while to come back with his injury.
Now, Graham, the other full forward, Dittmar, a former Port Adelaide player.
Great.
He's kicked four tonight. Unbelievable stuff.
Yes, great stuff by Dittmar. And he's been... really, in some ways, Ken, a one-man band up in the forward area. Obviously, four goals out of four. You can't have much more than that. That left-foot snap was good stuff. I mean, left-foot goals are required from time to time by full forwards. They've got to go both ways. And Dipmar proved he's got that... he is a left-footer.
He is.
I mean, he can go the other way, though, and kick right-foot goals also. He's that sort of a player. He's starting to impress me, although, as Rick Davies said, he sometimes drops the easy marks.
He does. OK, well, let's look at the winners now from round four of the Foundation Cup, Graham, and we certainly have an interesting situation. The Bulldogs are finished third by 34 points.
That was the battle of the low boats, Ken. And somebody had to win.
Exactly. North, that was a good game, North and South.
Oh, great game. And South were dead unlucky, Ken. I've said many times that poor old John Reid hasn't won a game against North in his 3 and a bit years as coach of South, and once again he's been left holding the tickets.
Good game, too, and West Adelaide beat the Tigers by 5 points.
You'd be rapt, wouldn't you? West Adelaide getting up the Bloods. They're a funny side. Enigmatic team, is that word?
What does it mean?
Well, it means they're liable to do something, but liable to do nothing also. And they come from the dead that night to win that one to a certain degree. Glenelg seemed to be, Glenelg didn't quite get hold of their game, did they? And West has won a game they probably thought they would have lost.
And there's the table after round four, Nord on top and having a marvellous season so far.
Well, Ken, they can't miss out. They've won tonight. Yep. They've now got four wins on the trot. That's 8 points they should be. We haven't covered tonight's games, of course. And South, I guess, are favourites, but if Glenelg beat them down, where is it, Ken? Mount Compass, I think.
Mount Compass.
On Sunday or Saturday. One of those days, anyhow. If they'll win, they'll get the chance to play North in the grand final.
No chance, Port?
No chance, Ken. No, the percentage is too poor.
OK, well, there's the prize money. First prize, $17,500, which is not a bad prize. Fifth to ninth, $5,700. So certainly nothing to be sneezed at there. Prize money for the Foundation Cup. We'll come back with more footy right after the break.
Unfortunately, we couldn't get hold of Russell Johnson. He's left the club. He's on his way down to Millicent. But it's my privilege and pleasure to welcome Scott Hodges. Scotty, I walked past there and I saw you sitting in the stand, and I thought to myself, well, how do you feel playing for the Crows and tonight watching Port Adelaide?
Well, coming out here tonight, I mean, I'd love to be out there and put the old black and white Guernsey on again. But it is a real strange feeling, I suppose, sitting in the outer watching the guys. But, you know, they're doing a great job out there tonight. And, you know, they're up by about 3 goals, so they don't need me out there.
I know that you spent a fair bit of time training with Port Adelaide, and then you had a little bit of trouble with the Crows. Now everything's fixed up now. You're happy to be down there. How are you finding it down there?
Well, the first couple of weeks I was finding it pretty tough to adapt to the training. The training is a lot more intense, and but at the moment I'm gradually building my way up there, and I'm very happy the way things are going. Things are coming along very slowly. You know, my kicking hasn't been too good, but you know, like last year, you know, I took a little bit of time, but you know, you can't take too much time in the AFL, and you know, hopefully this week, well, tomorrow night, I can get a few kicks and convert.
What about Russell Johnson? Going down to Millicent, I know I was going to interview him a couple of seconds ago, but were you a bit surprised that he decided to go to the country after, you know, the time he spent at Port?
Yeah, I was very surprised. I know that his ankle was causing him a bit of concern, and getting dropped from the Crows back to Port Adelaide. I mean, I thought, you know, a captain from last year, definitely he would have been playing another 2 or 3 more years with Ports, and I mean, it was a big shock to hear he was going to Millicent. I mean, at Millicent now, I reckon they got about 4 or 5 blokes from Port Adelaide.
When you're looking at it, I know Harrison coaches down there, but young Smallridge impresses me in the centre.
Yeah, he's very impressive. I mean, last year I think he won the Sandover medal but was ineligible because of suspension. But, you know, he's one of those centermen that is similar to Steve Williams, busts in there, grabs a ball, gets a hard ball, and, you know, feeds it out. And, he's a great player, and he showed what sort of class he is with the game against Sturt, I think it was.
Yeah, well, Scotty, 153 goals last year, the McGarry medalist. Every time the Crows come out on the ground, I watch, and I know everyone else in South Australia watches you with interest. All the best of luck this year, and you've got everyone in South Australia right behind you.
Thanks very much, Rick.
Rick Davies there talking to one hell of a nice guy, and that's Scotty Hodges, and he's a fine player. You best players quickly, Graham?
Well, Ken, I think Darren Smith, egg on my face, I said half forward wouldn't suit him. Best player for Port so far, both Williams boys, and George Fiace that quarter was brilliant. And I think without question, Adam Saliba's had most possessions with North. He looks good. Dipmar, full forward, 4 goals, and Clompy around the packs has done well also.
OK, let's now take you back to Ian Day for the exciting.
He's up the ground that will give him the football, and that certainly helps.
I'd agree with that, Ken. He's not unlike Scotty Hodges, actually in build and style, and Port Adelaide would love him to be as good. Getting the ball away there for Port Adelaide was Grimm. Kicks into attack up towards the half forward line. Coming out to meet it now is Tyler. Gets it away. Russell Boyd on the half forward line. Smith provides the screen. Boyd hooks around the corner in towards the forward pocket. Well read there by Jason Rowe. Gets it out wide. Turner gives it away to Parsons in turn. Or North a chance here at centre wing. Barrett clear. Goes for the run, will come back in board, kicks out the ball, out towards full four, the half forward line, and there is Simmons. Simmons now can't score from there, gets a lead into the pocket from Dittmar, going to give the boy a chance. Oh, he's swallowed by Port Adelaide defenders, couldn't get through the pack, and finally coming away is Grimm. Grimm goes towards centre wing, kicks long up there, well played up there on the half forward line, getting back on the ball, Smith, Perkins, Turner, going through, oh, farm out Riley, Perkins again. A lot of sleight of hand ball there. Finally, it's farmed towards the half forward line. Smith gets it out, puts it in towards Boyd. He can't get it. Jason Rowe back in defence for North Adelaide, and he gets a chance to get the kick away.
Rowe back towards the half-back flank, almost a mark on that occasion to Kemp, I think it was. Taken by Mark Williams. Mark Williams to brother Stephen. Stephen concedes ground and goes back towards Phillips in the middle of the ground. Williams now. Kick number 3 towards half forward. Players contest the football, and the ball is being held to a number of players. On the bottom was young Mackay, who's come onto the ground.
Very interesting there, interviewing Scotty, and he's still there, coming up into the ground.
kids there. Also, very, very popular player, Scott Hodges, and a great player. And it was interesting, Ken, coming up, Kill's giving a bit of a whipping.
Not too hard, Jumper. You're out of breath. I thought you were fit. Abernethy takes the football, but hands it straight over to Bennett. Bennett towards centre-half, Ford coming out to Delaney in front, and he takes the mark. Delaney has a player loose here. Warden, that's Mark Warden, the new player onto the ground. Back to Delaney. Delaney from the half-back flank. Goes towards Hutton at centre wing. Don't take the mark. Tackled by, on that occasion, Marshall. Jennifer, stolen by Parsons. Back towards Noonan. Noonan up towards half forward. North LA, oh, pushing the back. That's as far as the nose on your face. And against the big man, Greg Phillips, and it goes towards Bennett. Bennett. Kick number six into the pocket, looking out there for Dittmar. Beautifully put.
Yes, Ken, well, without this fella, they would have scored, because they've scored four goals. The big fella's kicked the four, and looking very, very sharp up there, moving, getting in front spot. He really looks like a full forward.
He's kicked four, comrade Rick Davies. Kick number six. It's in Graham Campbell's pocket. It's coming back, but nowhere near enough, and only a point to North Adelaide. They go to 4-6, Port 8-6.
Yes, well, the competition, really, everyone says it's going to be a little bit down, but tonight's performance with these two sides, North Adelaide and Port Adelaide, in at the football, in at it hard, and that's what everyone comes down to have a look at. And Port Adelaide just edging their way in front.
Obviously, Bruce Abernethy is not at centre wing anymore. Here's a chance. Dittmar slips it across. Atkinson, Saliba fires it up towards full forward. Leap on. Back in defence, it's Aber. I was about to say he's not at centre wing anymore. He seems to be playing in the back line as he gets it out wide. Kemp with the pace. Kicks towards the half-forward line. Smith out in front. Turner there with him. Coming across to cut the ball off is Stephen Riley. Well done, Smith, to get rid of him. Hughes around the corner. Jennifer needs to get the handball away. Mackay's the runner. Into the pocket. Port Adelaide through Boyd. Slipped it in. Stephen Williams going to get run down. Kicks and misses. Brilliantly done by the North Adelaide defence to cover the loose leads. And Stephen Williams just could not get the ball away quickly enough.
Yeah, you can see there the Port Adelaide supporter. She can smile at the moment because they're four or five goals up. But Ken, a bad miss by Stephen Williams.
Yes, he was. He kicked 4 points tonight. As we see the ball contested at centre wing, thrown out by Mark Williams. Jennifer ran into a brick wall. Gets it out towards Hutton. Coming in there is Smallridge. The ball on his boot very quickly up towards full forward, and a good mark has been taken by Tylor. That ball in his boot very quickly, yes, Smallridge.
Yes, he certainly did. He's had a number of touches tonight. Very, very impressive. 18 touches, and you can see there that, look at Tyler. Eyes on the footy. Nothing much Tasker can do there.
Tyler on a very acute angle. Kick number six. He's kicked 2-1. In fact, he's kicked 3-1. It's a great goal. Port Adelaide's ninth.
Yes, well, Tyler, number 24, you can see him in your screen there, and you can have a look here. Smallridge, beautiful movement. Really does look like Brown. Got the ball onto his boot very, very quickly, and you can see there Tyler taking the ball out in front of his eyes. Beautiful take, and a very, very difficult kick from there. Not a big run-up to goal. Just popped it through, and there's the little goal umpire putting up the two fingers. A good goal there by Port Adelaide.
Abernethy's gone to a half-back flank. 9-7 to 4-6. Darren Mackay seeing in screen there. He's gone to centre wing. Atkinson kicks the ball to the half-forward line. Off the fingers going through there was Marshall. Marshall hooks around the corner high. It's not a very good kick. Port Adelaide defence looking for it. Oh, Saliba over the top, but Abba's been paid the mark. He stood his ground extremely well. Watch young Adam Saliba put the saddle on, or did everything but. Port Adelaide come out of defence. Through Abba, up towards the centre wing spot. Parsons couldn't grab it. Oh, a chance for Hutton now, flanked by Stephen Williams. Hutton puts it out on the leaders. Tyler can't get this one. The ball goes to the line. The pace of Boyd gets him there first, but he can't keep the ball in play, and it's a throw in on the half forward left flank. Port Adelaide in attack.
Yes, well, beautiful movement there by Port Adelaide. You can see Tyler, he has to be in front, Ken, doesn't he? He has to go forward, and he has to make that front spot, because Port Adelaide will just place the ball out in front of him.
There certainly were some good players down the field, as we see Kemp rock and roll, taken on that occasion by Ryan, back towards the centre wing position. Smallridge there works hard. did that cleverly. Smallridge did it perfectly, and a good kick at that too, into the square. It'll go, it might have almost carried all the way, but good defensive work by Young Turner, but he was small, he played that superbly.
Yeah, big contract for Young Turner tonight. We've mentioned it all the way along. Darren Smith really got on top early, but it's going to be a great credit to the young bloke if he can come and at least break even with Darren Smith at half forward.
North Ave working the ball out of defence. Klomp over to Tasker. Tasker back. Back to Klomp. Simmons. In fact, it was Turner. Over to Saliba. North Adelaide up towards centre-half forward it goes, but it's all Port Adelaide here through Wharton. Wharton from the half-back flank towards half-forward. They've got possession again to Stephen Williams, and the use of the football is superb by the Maggies. The lead comes from Tyler. The kick is too long. Over the top it goes. A chance now for Tasker. Tasker gives it over to Young Hart. Hart, the running player, out towards centre wing. There is Darren Smith, bounces perfectly for him. Back to Jennifer. They've got Port Adelaide players running everywhere. Jennifer up towards full four. Tyler is there, can't take the mark. Ball to ground. As we come away now through Rowe. Rowe back to Atkinson. Oh, gee whiz, that's a fit of the fumbles. Kicked off the ground. Saliba is there. Here we run down by Jennifer. Did it so easily. Jennifer got a handball away to Piachi. Goes short, and Hutton takes the mark. Over the top to Stephen Williams. Is not a good handball. He got out of it well. Back to Piachi. He's tackled this way, that way. Back onto his left foot. Into the pocket he goes. But big fella Parsons is back there, and he takes the mark.
Michael Parsons in the back pocket to edge North out of defence. Gets a lead from Peter Bennett. Grandstand side. He's going to give Bennett the leap. Couldn't get there. Jason Rowe, yeah, thought he's going to get a free kick. He is. Jason Rowe on the half-back line. Kicks towards the centre wing spot. Kick number 8. Bennett in front. Over the top came Young Grimm. Ball forced now to Williams. Greg Phillips showing a bit of speed. Caught on his left leg. Hooks in towards the lead now of Tyler. Within there, over the top. Tasker first there. Boyd rides the bump. They go in hard. Hart gets it out to Perkins. Klomp now. Tasker. Tasker's clear, and he'll go for a run. Mark Williams trying to cut him off. He gets the kick away. He's got nothing to kick to at all. Once more, and it's going to be Foster. Gets there first for Port Adelaide. Slips it over to Hughes. Hughes in turn, the running player out there is Mark Williams. He goes once again for Tyler's going to get the sit. Oh, a lot of pushing and shoving there. Michael Parsons back in defence. Bradley Ryan sets it up now for Turner. Back to Parsons, caught on the left leg, edges it back towards centre wing. Grimm hooks around the corner in towards Port Adelaide's pocket. Once again, Tyler gets the leap. Bradley Ryan over the top into the pocket. Kemp hooks in towards goal. The umpire goes galloping, and that's out on the full. And the penalty free kick will be taken by North Adelaide in defence.
Good movement by Port Adelaide. They just can't finish it off. They're not putting the ball out in front of Tyler. He's making all the moves. They're just putting the ball in a little bit too high for him. But Port Adelaide seem to be on top all over the ground.
They certainly do, Rick, that's for sure. Tasker with a long kick back towards the half-back flank. Off hands, goes to Atkinson, but it's stolen by McKay. Over to Kemp. Kemp from the pocket towards full forward. There is Rowe, but the ball beats the player out of play.
Well, Ken, what do you think North Adelaide can do from here? They've got big Dittmar up forward, getting a lot of the plays, kicked 4 goals, but they don't seem to be able to get the ball up to him enough.
They can't get it past centre, Rick. They cannot get the ball past centre at the moment. Their running players have dropped completely out of the game. Smith, Atkinson, Smallridge. This is a player that's controlling the square to Williams. Appear to get a push in the back. Riley's in there. It's heavy body work. Finally comes back towards Parsons. Back towards centre wing. A push in the back. That was clear. And the free kick will be taken by Grimm. And the youngster. Kick number 5 to Shane Grimm. Towards full forward it goes. Bronte. In fact, Michael Parsons is there. Stolen by Kemp. In towards goal. And it's home for Port Adelaide. Goal number 10.
Yes, well, the difference between the two sides, as I see it, Darren Smith's been just completely on top across that half-forward line. Little fella, Smallridge in the centre, and you can see there over the top, number 28, didn't go to ground. A beautiful bit of movement there. Kemp, well, he's a rover, so he's got to be in the opportune place. You can see there, kicking the ground, curly, long hair. Beautiful goal there by Port Adelaide. They'll be hard to beat from here.
10-8 to 4-6. The Magpies lead by 38 points, appearing to have now a stranglehold on the game. Klomp, Mark Williams, the two strong men. Back towards Hutton, he can't pick it up. Parsons in there, slips it out towards centre wing. Atkinson needs a runner. Obliging is Perkins, slips it over further still. Simmons from centre wing, puts it in towards the pocket. Saliba's there, one grab, can't complete it. In they go hard. Fiacci slips the ball out to Ginova. Sleight of hand there, back looking for Fiacci. Did it pretty well. Marshall against the tide. Gives a chance now in the pocket to Barrett. Hooks around the corner up over the top. Bennett thumps it towards his goal line. The bounce will determine. Wharton, Dittmar at the bottom of the pack. Phillips over the top. Slips the ball out. And it's Grimm who'll come away for Port Adelaide. Time to have a bounce. Kick number six. The leader's on from Smith. He's got the ball on the half back line, almost snookers himself. The running par out there is Mackay at centre wing, kicks long in towards the half forward line. Coming to meet it is Boyd off top, flash there with Perkins. Michael Parsons loses it in there, Smallridge. Perkins, now Rowe. Centre wing, and it's a good mark to Klomp, slips it through. Noonan through the half forward line. In the pocket is Dittmar. Makes a metre to get there, won't quite get there, and the ball is out of play, and there's a blue at centre-half back.
Yeah, just a little bit of a discrepancy there about who punched the ball away there, I think, Daisy. You can see Rowe there, Stephen Riley. Well, of course, he'd probably step backwards, but I've never ever seen him step backwards. And you've got Hughes there, Perkins. So a little bit of an altercation back there, but Port Adelaide controlling this game.
A bit of fire into the game as we see North Adelaide into attack going towards the golf course end. Klomp, the hurry kick back towards the centre-half for, but Phillips takes the mark. And a 50 metres? No, not. Kick number five to Greg Phillips. In fact, he handballs. Goes to Abernethy. Was the right option. Abernethy, a lovely kicker of the football, up towards centre-half forward. Mark Williams up high and takes a good mark. It's all Port Adelaide. Over to brother Stephen Williams with his 21st possession, Mark Williams. Towards full forward it goes. Tasker with an opportunity now for North Adelaide. Kicks back towards the centre wing. Here's a chance for Atkinson. Can he mark? Oh, Hutton almost. Ball towards the band line. In fact, it's out of play. Down the umpire right on the spot and calls the ball out of play.
Yeah, I think there's going to be a bit of a different idea this year. South Adelaide showed us last week that they're going to try and stop North Adelaide's quick play. And, of course, Port Adelaide tonight especially not only have stopped North Adelaide's quick handball, but they've been right on top and they've had better players up forward.
Holding the ball decision goes the way of Mark Williams. Umpire Stephen Semmer in charge. Williams from the check side of centre wing. 11 kicks, 11 handballs. A fine game from the veteran. Oh, big mark. Michael Parsons had the sit. Although he's given away a free kick to Hughes, didn't pick it up myself, but Hughes has got the ball. Well, to me, he took the mark. Maybe he got a hand in the back beforehand. Rick Davies, you saw it. What do you think?
Eyes on the footy, clean mark.
Kick in high by Hughes. Parsons getting back on it. Tasker there, Tyler as well. Bradley Ryan. Parsons gets it over now to Ben Hart, in turn Klomp. The running plough was Noonan, doesn't want him. Goes to centre wing and Simmons. North Adelaide off the half back line. Perkins, who's played well, steadies to have a look. Kicks long to the half forward line. Mick Redden's up there now. The big fellow leaps, can't bring it down. Abba, Fiacci lost it. In there comes Abernethy again. Kicks back towards centre wing. Well taken by Smallridge. Gee, and he and young Kemp don't look dissimilar. 50 metres. 12 kicks, 9 handballs. And Port Adelaide have got a fine acquisition in this not-so-young man, they tell me. He's 27 years of age. Of course, I'd like to be that myself, but whatever. Hey, gee, how's that for 50 metres? That's near 100. He's gone from centre-half back to full forward. Whatever, he's looking just a little bloodied. Gary Smallwood. Smallridge. A recruit from the West. 40 metres out, right in front. That's a nice-looking kick, but he has hooked it for a point.
Yes, well, he certainly is a no-nonsense player, number three. A little bit of blood coming out of that left-hand eye. As you can see there, beautiful mark. Graham Campbell barks in the back line that it's not a left-handed eye, but it certainly is. And unfortunately for Port Adelaide, he missed.
That was a terrible 50-metre penalty kick. That was a 50-metre penalty kick. Well, I'm a Dutchman. As Parsons comes off for North Adelaide, the ball going towards half-forward, but again, if they happen to get the ball past centre North Adelaide, they hit a brick wall with Port Adelaide's half back line, and Fiacci, Abernethy and Phillips, they go short. Kemp He can't take the mark. Chance now for Barrett. Barrett of North Adelaide up towards full four. Ditmar is there. Delaney, one on one. Simon Hill, new pile on the ground, trying to crash through Delaney. Missed the football. Chance for Atkinson around his body. It's all Port Adelaide here. Take your pick. Delaney takes him up. Four Port Adelaide players. In fact, five Port Adelaide players. Over the top he goes to Abernethy. Now they're going to run the ball out. That's Mark Wharton with the footy at halfback towards centre wing. And in fact, he finds Hughes. Goes to Smallridge. He's in stripe. It goes in again. Gets it the second time. Did it cleverly. Goes over the top. Chance for Kemp. The two lookalikes. Up towards the forward pocket it goes. Chipping back there. Has a mark been paid? Yes, it has. And it's Stephen Riley will get the mark.
Yeah, well, you can see, Ken, that the young Smallridge and Kemp looks like a pup out of young Smallridge. Very long hair, but very, very talented players.
Stephen Riley edges the ball back towards centre wing. Over the top, that's the top mark by Port Adelaide's Brett Chalmers. Chalmers from the attack side of centre wing. Screws the ball in towards the half forward line. Gee, there was a lot of pushing and shoving there. The pace is on. Riley back. Oh, gee, he's gone for the line. The umpire's going to let it go, but it looked fairly intentional from up the back of the stand, I can assure you.
Yes, well, there wasn't much else he could do there. He had a dead end, you might say, and the only thing that he possibly could do is run the ball out of play.
Atkinson off, Mail back on, the throw in the forward pocket. Smith needs help. Geneva out of play in the same spot. About 10 metres around from the Port Adelaide goal. 10-9 to 4-6. 20 minutes gone of this second half. 21 minutes plus time on each quarter. Fighting hard for the ball was Williams. Gets it out. A chance for Ben Hart, or Klomp it was, at the bottom of the pack. Finally, Noonan gets it over to Klomp in turn. Ryan. Ryan off the half back line. North Adelaide towards centre wing. Josh Mayle, that's a top mark. Used his body well to get rid of Piachi. And he'll send North Adelaide into attack. Peter Bennett will be his target if he can get him clear. Now he gives the lead towards the half forward line. Barrett's going to be the leaper. And he's got the ball about 60 metres out. Gives a chance now. Ditmar on the lead. Delaney there. Delaney gets rid of him. Ditmar, Delaney. Delaney through. Too good. Kemp the runner. Defensive corner of the big centre square. Kicks out long. Smith out in front. Looks for a runner. He's got one coming through now. Boyd 30 metres out. Gives a chance. Kemp. Kemp in turn. Geneva. Point blank range. Goals!
Well, footy at its best there by Port Adelaide. Started from the half-back line. And look at the Port Adelaide supporters. Have a bow peep at that. I'm a Port Adelaide supporter. Delaney, I thought that Ditmar could have possibly tried a little bit harder there, but Kemp pushing the ball forward, running the ball into the open. Beautiful mark there by Big Smith. You can see why he's a very important player. Very, very unselfish. Smallridge really shaping up as the best man on the ground. And Geneva finishes the playoff.
Well, you certainly won't see better movement than that. Port Adelaide 11-9, North 4-6. That's the best passage of play all night, in my opinion. Back in the middle. Bounce. Redden, Chalmers, who's going to be a very good player, young Chalmers, also, in my opinion, Noonan worked, in fact, it was Hart who worked hard for the football, over to Rowe, Rowe towards half forward, and a good mark has been taken here by Simmons. Well, he has a loose player, which is Simon Hill at centre half forward. He'll run into an open goal, he shouldn't miss from here, Simon Hill. Kicks from point blank range, it's home, goal number 5 to North.
Yes, it was great to see Simon Hill back in the play, very bad knee injury. Upsetting his career, and you can see there on his right knee, a bit of a bandage there. Coming, country boy, coming from Ardrossan, so I know a little bit about him. Showed an enormous amount of talent at centre-half forward. There he is, number 23. Looks like he's come back, and it's wonderful to see a young fellow like that coming back after a bad knee injury and putting through a very, very valuable goal. And let's face it, North Adelaide certainly need a couple of goals from here.
You're dead right. Port Adelaide 11-9, North 5-6. The second goal kicker for North Adelaide, Simon Hill. Ditmar has the other four. At the bounce. 22 minutes. Almost three-quarter time. Redden came over the top. They can't get it out. Saliba in trouble. Farmed out now to Marshall. Off the boot it goes towards the half-forward line. Foster's first there. With him is Simmons. Man for man they go. Simmons, well done. Back to Peter Bennett. Slips it in. Oh, intercepted brilliantly there by Foster. Gives your teammate a chance in Phillips. Now it's Kemp. He's edged off the ball. Noonan. screws one in towards the half forward line. Getting back on it is Chalmers, and that's a top mark, young man. Kept his head up, his eyes on the ball, under pressure, took it well at centre half back. It's his sixth kick. As he edges the ball out towards centre wing, siren sounds at Port Adelaide by 29 points.
Yes, well, it doesn't matter what North Adelaide do. They just can't get a forward, apart from Dittmar, who's kicked four. Port Adelaide completely in charge. Chalmers, Grimm, they've got a number of young players that we haven't seen. There he is in your screen, Smallridge. Very, very exciting. Cinnamon, a little bit of a gap over the eye. But Port Adelaide completely controlling this game until three-quarter time.
And at three-quarter time, it is Port Adelaide, as Rick has told you, certainly in control. They lead 11-9-75, North Adelaide 5-6-36, a margin of 39 points. You're watching Friday Night Live Football on Nine, Wide World of Sports.
Three-quarter time here at Football Park in the first quarter. Port Adelaide 4-4-28 led North Adelaide 2-4. At halftime they were still in front, 7-6-4, 5-0. They've careered away into the third quarter, 11-9-5-6.
Yes, the Magpies and Tyler 3, very good up forward. Smith 2, Boyd, Cetri 2, and Dittmar still the leading goal kicker for the Roosters on 4.
Kicking 4. Well, Graham Campbell, of course, Rick with him on the boundary. Graham, have you seen Mark Tyler's game up forward?
Oh, well, Ken, he's warm to the task. He played quite well that quarter, yes. That term. But the first half, he was well held by Sean Tasker. The big improver was Roger Delaney that quarter, Ken. He never gave Michael Dittmar a look in. But Mark Tyler got that goal, and I guess, you know, he had to do something up there because he is the key forward in this Port Adelaide setup. Yes, if somebody set up top, he'll have a big year, I think.
Yes, he certainly looks good, Graham, and he takes the ball out in front of his eyes, and he's a very, very good kick for goal.
Well, he is, Rick, and, well, we've seen two good full forwards tonight. Dittmar's going to be a player, no question about that. OK, Delaney got on top that quarter, but the first half was all Michael Dittmar.
Yes, well, Smallridge also, Graham, down there. How did you see his game? Well, left-footer coming across from the west?
Well, at half-time, Ken was saying he was best on the ground. I didn't agree at that stage. I do now, though. Smallridge has been a very effective player all night. Gets his nose over the ball, plenty of guts, and really does, when he gets hold of the ball, use it to advantage. He's a good player.
All All right, Graham, we'll certainly interesting game at three-quarter time with Port Adelaide. Rick have taken completely control.
Can you see North getting back in?
No, I cannot. I cannot. As we take you back to our caller, Ian Day. Here we go.
Port Adelaide by 39 points. Umpire Stephen Semler. And Michael Redden, a whimsical smile on his face. He's come all that way down from the country. And North Adelaide get a shellacking. But even so, Michael enjoy the game of football. What a wonderful player he's been for North Adelaide and South Australia. And one of the most likeable characters in football in this state. 11-9 to 5-6 at the bounce. It'll be Redden from the right against Chalmers from the left. Stands the ground. Chalmers gets the thump away. It was Klomp. Gets it back now. Redden hooks around the corner in towards the half forward line. Bennett flips it out. Barrett now needs a runner. Coming through Saliba. Saliba has a flying shot again. But gee, the young fellow. I reckon he's missed three or four when in a position to kick goals this evening. He seems to come through that half forward line, Rick, but he can't complete it.
Yes, he certainly does. And it'll be interesting to see what Michael Noonan. I know it's only early. I know they're only Foundation Cup games. But he'd have been a little bit disappointed with tonight's performance because Port Adelaide have been pretty well on top on in most positions.
North Adelaide now with the football back towards Dittmar. And Dittmar takes the mark. Dittmar with a chance now to kick goal number five.
And isn't it amazing? A couple of seconds ago, I looked up and I saw Josh Marr. I thought, well, where's he going? And all of a sudden, he's popped it across to Dittmar. What happened across there?
I've got no idea, Rick. No idea at all. Gee, Dittmar now with a chance to kick goal number five. Kick number seven directly in front. And he has got it. Goal number six to North Adelaide.
Yes, well, I don't know whether that was a goal to North Adelaide or the umpire was a give-me because I'm dead set sure. You can see there Josh Marr nicking off. He could see that Big Dittmar was by himself in the square, but I thought it was the other way around. I thought actually for a couple of seconds there that he was going the wrong way, but so be it. The ball went down to Dittmar, and he took a beautiful...